This is Father Ian Rosal of the Salesians of Don Bosco, and this is Live Life in Lent. This Lenten season, I ask you to practice three things, and that is to be silent, to be relentless, and to be excellent. In this episode, let us try to see how we could become excellent. In Christian terms, when we think about being excellent, what comes to our mind is that we have to be holy. And in fact, this is our call to live holy lives. Pero ito ang problema. Kasi minsan, pag iniisip pa lang natin yung salitang holy, kinakabahan na tayo. Bakit? Kasi parang ang hirap-hirap buhayin. Kasi kung iisipin mo, kailangan pag inisip mong ang isang tao ay holy, isang tao ay banal, ang unang pumapasok sa isip natin ay ito. Dapat ang taong yan, walang kasalanan. For us, at times we think of holiness as perfection. And perfection is being sinless. Pero sa totoo lang, sa buhay natin ngayon, wala namang makakabuhay niyan eh. We cannot live life without falling into sin. Because human as we are inclined to fall. And at times, to fall into sin. And that is why for me, my definition of holiness is our continuous struggle to be good and to do good. And if this is our definition of holiness, holiness is indeed attainable in this life. Since I am a member of the Salesians of Don Bosco, I have to quote my own founder. He has given his voice a saying which from his time up until now is so true in coming up with young people who live holy lives. Don Bosco told his Bosconians to live our ordinary duties extraordinarily well. Oo nga no, sa totoo lang, lahat tayo kayang buhayin yan. Kung ikaw ay estudyante, you can live holy life. Kunwari, your primary duty is to study. Kaya nga, kunwari, pag uwi mo ng bahay at meron kang assignment, ang unang-una mong gagawin ay gawin ka agad yung assignment at hindi ka agad magko-computer o di kayo manunood ng sine. Bakit? Kasi ang unang-unang duty mo ay mag-aral. And if you're able to study very well, you are doing your ordinary duty extraordinarily well. And for Don Bosco, this is the way to holiness. This is the way to become excellent. At kung titingnan po natin mabuti, anong dahilan? Bakit ang isang tao ay mamumuhay ng kaaya-aya? Why will he live an excellent life? At alam po natin, alam niyo po, kung titingnan niyong mabuti, marahil kung ang isang tao ay gagawa ng kabutihan at magpapakabuti, ito'y dahil ang kanyang puso ay punong-puno ng pagmamahal. I would like to think that Don Bosco, first of all, did his ordinary duties ordinarily well, to show his love for his mother, Mama Margaret. Dahil mahal na mahal niya ang kanyang ina, gagawin niya ang lahat para matulungan ang kanyang ina. But ultimately, I would like to think that Don Bosco lived his life extraordinarily well because he loved God above all. And he knew deep down inside of him that if he had a God who loved him excellently, he was also challenged to live his life as excellent as possible. And Don Bosco was canonized a saint because he lived his life extraordinarily well. And he has passed on this tradition to the Bosconians, and he has passed this on to the world. Indeed, we can be holy if we do our ordinary duties extraordinarily well. And this is Father Ian Rosal of the Salesians of Don Bosco, and this is Live Life in Lent. God bless you all.